Good morning, students. Today I will teach you on the topic called liquid. As you can see on the screen, small balls like structure. What are these? These are actually molecules. If you compare the image what I had given in the previous class, you can see that here in the picture the molecules are quite far apart. Since molecules are quite far apart, therefore intermolecular force of attraction is less. Since intermolecular force of attraction is less, the molecules can easily slip over each other, due to which they can flow. So liquids are called fluids. They are actually less rigid as compared to solid, because molecules are bit far apart. Here you may feel that it is can be compressed, but we can compress. But as comparison to gases, it can be compressed only to a very limited extent that may not be noticeable in a very easy way. As you can see on the screen, students, this is the molecular arrangement of liquids, in which molecules are far apart. If somebody will ask you a very simple question, what is the difference in terms of exerting pressure between solid and liquid, you should be able to answer that in solids, particles exerts pressure downward, but in liquid molecules are far apart and they are free, so they exert pressure in downward direction and sideways. Since molecules are free to move, therefore when we flow liquid from one container to other container, the molecule slips, so it is becomes easy for us to transfer a liquid from one container to another container, and this may not be possible in solids, because here in case of solids the molecules do not slip and they are very strongly attracted to each other. Since molecules are quite far apart, so it becomes very easy for us to dissolve anything in liquid. If you take a glass of water and try to dissolve a spoon of salt into it, it becomes easier because the salt occupies the empty space in between the molecules of liquid. But if you try to mix 1 tablespoon of salt and 1 tablespoon of sugar, they may not mix with each other, because intermolecular space in case of solid is very high. Therefore diffusion doesn't take place much easily in solid, but diffusion is quite fast in terms of liquid. Now you can see on the screen molecules are there which are quite far, as you had seen in solids, liquids. This is the molecular arrangement in gases, where molecules are very far to each other. Since molecules in gases are very far to each other, an intermolecular force of attraction is very less. Therefore, gases do not have any fixed shape and size. Since in gases, molecules are very far apart due to lack of intermolecular force of attraction, the molecules can very easily slip. Therefore, they can flow and they are called as fluids. They always take the shape of the container in which we are trying to put in. You can see, students, on the screen, the molecules are quite far apart. Since molecules are quite far apart, once we apply pressure, therefore molecules do come close to each other. So we can say that gases are highly compressible. Since in gases, molecules are very far apart and they are in state of random motion. So you should know, if somebody asks you what is this random motion called, this random motion of molecules are known as Brownian motion. Student, now let us have a comparative study between solid, liquid and gas. Since you are in class 6 and you should know mass. If you do not know, please pay attention to know what is mass. Mass means quantity of matter contained in a body. Since matter remains same in all the states, therefore solids, liquids and gases do have definite mass. Now let us talk about shape. Since in solids, molecules are closely packed, so they have got definite shape. In liquids, molecules are bit far apart, so they take the shape of the container. In gases also, molecules are quite far apart, so they also take the shape and size of the container. In terms of volume, solids have got definite volume, liquids also have definite volume. Gases do not have definite volume because in gases, molecules are very far apart and they undergo rapid motion, due to which they do not have a definite volume. Since in solids, molecules are very closely packed and it is not possible to compress them, due to which solids cannot be compressed. In liquids, molecules are a bit far apart, so we can compress liquid to a very limited degree. But in terms of gases, you had seen on the screen that molecules were far apart, and once you apply the pressure on the molecules comes close to each other. Therefore, in gases, compression is possible to a higher degree. I have told you, students, in solid, molecules are very closely packed, due to which they cannot flow. But liquids and gases can flow, so they are called as fluids. Since in liquids, molecules are very closely packed, so we say that they are highly rigid. To rigid means to say that it becomes difficult to change their shape. In liquids, molecules are not very closely packed, so they are less rigid. And in terms of gases, they are least rigid. Already regarding molecules, I have said, in solids they are very closely packed, liquids they are quite far apart, in gases they are the farthest apart. Now students, we are dealing with the last topic, that is called kinetic energy. Kinetic energy means it is the energy possessed by a body by virtue of its motion. In solids, you have seen that molecules are very closely packed. So we can say that in solids, since molecular force of attraction was very high, due to which kinetic energy was very less. Once you come to liquids, since molecules were quite far apart, therefore kinetic energy could be seen in liquids. Once you compare to gases, since the molecules were very far apart, therefore kinetic energy in gases was to a maximum degree.